Good morning. I'm Myrna Castrejón. I'm the president and CEO of the California Charter Schools Association, here to represent the charter school community's strenuous opposition to AB 1316. CCSA has a very strong record on accountability. We blew the whistle on the criminals of the A3 scheme in 2018 and called on the CDE and superintendent to investigate and take appropriate and immediate action. But this bill is not about accountability, and nor is it about parity. The bill actually discriminates against charter students by slashing non-classroom-based funding by 30%, but not for districts with independent study programs. AB 1316 also falls far short of holding authorizers accountable. So you just heard Mr. Fine speak to that. In fact, it actually doubles down on the perverse incentives of increased oversight fees, which we know that motivated unscrupulous authorizers in the past. More importantly, this bill eliminates student-centered, flexible schedules and the discretion necessary for teachers and paraprofessionals to meet student needs. Further, AB 1316 unravels that historic compromise shepherded by Governor Newsom in 2019 by relitigating settled issues related to site-based schools, despite the fact that the regulations for implementing these new laws have not even yet been initiated. How can we fully engage when recent legislative agreements are being dismissed and punitive approaches against an entire sector are being advanced in this bill? This bill targets families who've been failed by site-based settings. These charters do serve a highly mobile student population, up to 17%, and we're still talking about a fraction of the whole student body of California, less than 3%. So for the pregnant or the working teen or the migrant student who follows the crops or the students with disabilities who have flocked to personalized learning programs in the pandemic, AB 1316 will strain and even foreclose opportunities for these students to receive the education they deserve. These are our most vulnerable students. This is not equity, and this is not California. We respectfully asked for your no vote, and I'm happy to answer questions.